She certainly doesn't handle it in the most mature way. Let's just put it that way. But she grows. So at the end of season two, Midge gets so overwhelmed by being invited to join Shy Baldwin on the road that she forgets that she's very nearly engaged to Benjamin and says yes. And she goes to see Lenny Bruce perform. And I think Midge has a big realization that doing this career and being completely invested in it, which she's waffled with for quite a lot of the season, means that she's gonna be alone forever, that she can't have anyone relying on her and she can't be there for other people in the same way that she needs to be present in this career. So she goes back to Joel just for one night. Just for some company. And that's where we end the season. So we begin season three, literally still in bed with Joel, and then some shenanigans ensue. Abe and Rose are in an interesting place with Midge's comedy. They know about it. The big secret's finally out in the open. I weirdly think that Abe is more accepting than Rose is. I think Rose feels really betrayed by the idea that this daughter that she was so close to, that she saw so much of herself in and had poured so much of herself into, has undermined her, has betrayed her trust this way, is doing something that's so unladylike and so unexpected of her and really frowned upon at this time. Midge has asked Abe to come see her perform outside of that one awful, awful night that he saw in the Catskills. And they are waffling when we first see them. There's still a lot of tension there, and there's a lot of change for all of them happening at once. Lenny, more than anyone else, has inspired Midge. I think she sees what she aspires to be in Lenny. I think she likes his style. She likes how bold and brave and smart he is, how quick he is. He's aspirational in his comedy, but also as a person. And on our show, on our fictional show, they've become friends. And their friendship deepens during this season. They have a really sweet relationship. There's so much support there, and they bounce off of each other. It's a very different relationship with Lenny than Midge has with any other character on the show. Between Lenny and Susie, those are the two people who told Midge that she could do it when maybe she wasn't even so sure that she could, and now she believes them. Alex and I talked a lot last season about how the honeymoon is over for Midge and Susie. They started this adventure, everything was fresh and new and shiny and exciting, and it kind of blows up a little bit in season two. They spend too much time together, you know, they become roommates. And a lot of friendships go through those kinds of waves. Any relationship where love is involved has ups and downs and overs and sideways and everything in between. This season, even more so than last season, they're being confronted with the reality of this road they've decided to walk down together. It's not always glamorous. It's not always easy. We've always joked on the show about how, you know, Midge and Susie joke about whether or not they're really friends. But I know that Midge believes that they're friends. And the idea of what Midge understands as friendship is tested in this season when Susie takes on Sophie Lennon as a client, who is Midge's mortal enemy, as she says, who's tried to screw her and end her career more than once. Midge is forced to understand that she can't be the center of everyone's universe all the time, that other people have other needs and need to be able to take care of themselves as well as her, and that you can maintain a friendship where everyone is getting what they need. That's a big piece of growth for Midge and a huge step forward in their relationship. Once they cross that hump, you see them both relax into a rhythm and a groove that we've never really seen from the two of them. They're having experiences together for the first time. They're having some experiences apart, and that makes their relationship deeper and more intimate. Midge comes from a very sheltered environment. She is accustomed to being the center of everyone's universe, including her own. That's how she's lived her entire life. And suddenly, not only is she not the center of the universe she thought she would be for the rest of her life, but this huge risk that she's taken in entering into this relationship with Susie is maybe headed the same way. When Midge finally says to Susie, I want you to be successful also, and I recognize that means that sometimes I have to compromise, is maybe the biggest piece of personal growth that Midge has experienced on the show so far.
Hey, guess what? Susie, who gets 10% of my salary, is gonna sit here and keep you company.
Very smooth.
See you after my show.